You! I'm talking to you! Do you have a steam heating system in your home? Is your DIY level a 0 or a 1 out of 10? Then you gotta watch this video. Mikey Pipes, Sunday morning, keeping it real, 8:32 in the morning, heading over to an emergency service call, not too far away in Cedarhurst. Customer has a gas-fired steam boiler. It is a rental property, and I do work for the property owner on multiple properties that he has. Yeah, like, Mikey Pipes, what are you doing? Why is there a Mr. Cool DIY, not one, but two ductless mini split systems in your garage? Well, you're gonna have to wait and stay tuned because I didn't buy it and I'm not endorsing it. What does that tell you? Good morning. I woke up, it was 36 degrees. I figured I'll come here a little bit sooner than 9. That's okay with you?
Yes.
Have you had the heat on?
Yes, so the heat's been on. It hasn't cooled out because I guess I took some of the water out of the
water. Okay. So I guess we need to do a little general service on it, make sure the water level is accessible and all that other good stuff. Okay, let's go see what's going on.
Do you mind if I ask you again to show me the water level thing?
Do I mind? Of course not.
It's not on, actually.
What's not on?
This means it's out of water, right?
Correct. And it appears to be full of water. If you can't tell by the side glass how much water is in it, assume it's full.
Okay.
I guess no one closed the valve, so then it wouldn't be that. That was not open fully. You manually add water how often?
When that light is on.
How often does that occur?
Almost never.
Okay, good. Let me get a bucket from the truck. You have a sink down here? No.
I don't. I have this bucket that I use that gets too heavy for me to pick up.
Oh, and where do you dump it?
I carry it up and throw it outside.
Oh, I thought that was a hole in the floor. Oh, that would have been nice to help. All right, so we're going to take some water out of the boiler and dump it. I guess the easiest way is outside, through front door, back door, side door. Alright. There is a lot of water in there. I'm gonna have to get another bucket. Very, very important that the water level of the boiler remains around half during operation of the boiler. So if you can't see it, assume there's too much water in there. Alright, the intensity of the water coming out of this 3/4 inch boiler drain has lowered. But what has not lowered is my sight glass water level. I'm starting to suspect that we have a lot of crud built up inside the valve body, and that's preventing the sight glass from displaying the true amount of water in the system. Again, just my food for thought, but that's what I'm starting to lean towards, and we may have to take this out to clean. So stay tuned. I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Well, we're actually slowly going down. My light on the low water cutoff has not come on yet. So it looks like we just had too much water in the system. All right, we're on bucket number 4. Granted, it's not a full 5-gallon bucket, but I have verified that my low water cutoff is functional because I have the low water light indicator there, and my sight glass is almost empty. So I'm gonna go to the truck, grab my tool bag. We're gonna take out the pigtail. We're gonna check this, make sure that's clear. All right, we're gonna start with this bottom gauge right here. It's gonna loosen up that nut. All right, and I'm gonna take out the bottom valve. Okay, I drained a lot of the water out of the boiler, so we're not gonna have anything come out of there, and I'm just gonna rinse that off there. Now, I'm gonna take one of the rods, protect the sight glass, I'm just gonna shove it in there. All right, I wanna see what comes out. Looks pretty cocky. See how it's draining better now? Much better. So, let's add some more water. I'm gonna get a good sense of the water level in the boiler now that that's clean. So let me just shove this in there while it's good. Excellent. Put this back in there. Okay, beautiful. And carefully, I'm gonna put the handle back in. Into the valve. Okay. Make sure we go back just a little bit like that and then tighten up the packing nut on the valve. Okay, now I'm gonna go back here and I'm gonna finish draining. I wanna get that as clean as possible. While that's draining, we're gonna make sure we turn the power off. We're gonna take out the pressure troll, removing the two wires, and then we're gonna take out the pigtail. You know I'm gonna blow on it. Yeah, you caught that on video. It's clear. All right, my pressure troll is back in place and wired. We're gonna turn the power back on. It's gonna do a power cycle of the low water cutoff. We're basically about empty here. Let me drain the rest of the water into the French drain that's right here and fill her back up. Okay. Let's fill her back up. She's basically empty right now, so we're gonna wait for the bottom of the boiler to fill up. And we're gonna stop it right around here, 5/8 full. That's what works for me, right around there. Be the light on the low water cutoff. This is the CG400, 24 volt low water cutoff. There's a probe in there. I don't know if you can see it. I'll get you in there. The probe right there that sits in the water and that senses the water level electronically. Okay, there we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the lesson learned here is if you have a steam heating system for your home, you must check that water level. If you can't see the water level, assume, and I don't like to assume anything, but you know what happens when you assume, you make an ass out of you and me. Assume the boiler is flooded and keep draining. Keep draining till nothing else comes out. And if you still see that water level, or you think it's full, you need to call a professional. Unless you are a professional, then you should call me and I'll give you a phone consult for 15 minutes. We'll save you 15% or less. No, it's actually not. 15 minutes is going to cost you $50 on the phone with me. Details in the description box down below. But if you got a steam boiler, you need to drain that once a month. It's in the manual. It's in the manual. Drain that boiler once a month. Prove that low water cutoff works. Keep that steam boiler water clean. Why? Because you need clean water. Clean water will boil at 212 degrees. Dirty water won't. So if dirty water won't boil at 212 degrees, it requires a lot more energy to boil that water to create steam, which is going to cost you money. Do you like spending money? No, like Ben Muller. Money! Keep your boiler clean. Mikey Pipes signing off.